online shoppers, listen up. You've probably been adding to cart since yesterday to take advantage of the big payday sale today. This morning, we are going to talk about the e-commerce landscape in the Philippines and where it's headed with Shopee Philippines director, Martin Yu. Hi, Martin. Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, good morning.
Okay, so Martin, tell us about the trends and the shift that you're seeing in terms of online shopping and the partners that you do business with.
Yeah, sure. You know, I mean, at the start of the pandemic, a lot of Filipinos really turned to online platforms to start buying their daily needs. In 2020, we saw this big growth in demand for essentials on our platform. And we shifted our strategy a little bit to focus on providing a wider selection of daily essentials, you know, from trusted brands and offering more vouchers and deals for our consumers so that they would find these kind of products. Also, another trend is that we're seeing is that a lot of people are now adopting to digital payments for their online transactions. In fact, in Shopee, we saw a fourfold uplift in orders completed with our e-wallet, Shopee Pay, last year across the region. So actually, if you're not so familiar with Shopee Pay, you can now use this to pay your bills, buy load, and send money to peers. Which is really exciting for us. And another one that I really noticed is that online platforms are now being used for social interactions. And when I say this, it's through games and live streams. You know, so at Shopee, we provide a lot of content for our users now for online shopping. In 2020, during the three-month period, the first 3 months of 2020, Shopee saw 200 million plays across the region in its in-app games. This includes, if you're familiar, Shopee Farm, Shopee Throw, which is, you know, a good time just to spend while you're shopping as well.
Uh-huh. And the shoppers don't get confused with so many things happening?
No, because I think it ties on to the overall shopping experience. You know, you play the game, so you get some promos to buy even more things, which is really exciting.
Ooh, okay, so it's a whole ecosystem you're building there. You mentioned this earlier. When you look at how shopping has gone digital, how much more items would you say are now sourced online? You know, people moving from, do we have an idea how many people have moved from traditional offline retailers to online retailers?
For this, it's hard for me to gauge. I think it's hard for me to gauge the whole market. But I do know there's been a shift, but it's a healthy, exciting one. I do know we're lagging. It's a growth in e-commerce that we're finding very positive for people.
Okay. So Martin, why don't you tell us what's hot and what's not? When you look at the categories, would fashion be the best seller, or is it more home improvement items flying off the shelves? I know that at one point diaper was the top selling item. Is it still?
Yeah, it's still up there. It's still really exciting. I do, one of the things I noticed during this pandemic lockdown is his home improvement. I think a lot of people are spending a lot more time being at home. So if you're at home, I guess you want to make sure that your house or where you're living is looking better than it was. And we're getting a lot of these even lampshades, bed products, including bed sheets. At the same time, of course, the demand for electronics continues to be very strong. So it's a good mix, actually. So you highlighted a few of these: home improvement, electronics, and fashion.
Mm-hmm. So we've just had the 7/7 sale, and now we're in the middle of a payday sale for July. Are these big sale events still big, or are people getting too familiar with them that they start to lose the spark? What do you think?
I think the familiarity is good, you know. So shoppers are definitely looking forward to our mega campaigns. Because, you know, during these times, you get the big discounts, the promos, and the rewards. So shoppers have different online shopping experiences themed days each month, which makes it exciting to look forward to every month, you know. It's still very, very exciting. I can actually quote a study that Facebook recently published that, you know, mega campaigns, 40% of Filipinos who buy online are still first-time online shoppers. So, you know, a lot of people who are not so aware and, you know, are just starting, or it's just their first time trying to shop online during these big sale days, which is, you know, I think it's still great. I know it's still great. And I can quote a few, right? So in 6/6 to 7/7 during our mid-year sale, we saw top brands from Shopee Mall see 15-fold increases in their orders against their normal day orders. And also, we're about to get into our mega shopping season, which is this 9/9 to 12/12 season, which is the big highlight for everyone who's looking to shop towards the end of the year.
Oh, wow. And that's even bigger than your mid-year sale?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, of course, you remember last year's 11-11 to 12-12 big Christmas sale. It was very, very exciting.
Uh-huh. So I guess that goes without saying that you think that the outlook for e-commerce for the rest of the year is that it's going to get even better and stronger?
Yeah, no, I think it's going to be very exciting.
And with, you know, the economy reopening a little bit more because of easing restrictions, you know, people will tend to go back to their old habits. They'll go to malls. Do you expect that, you know, you're going to lose some of the sales to the traditional brick and mortar stores later this year when restrictions ease, or no? You think, no, we're not going to plateau. There's still so much room to go for this.
So I think I've focused more on the deals that we're about to have, and it's really exciting. So I'm very, very happy to, my expectations are really good for e-commerce.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what's the next growth strategy for Shopee here in the Philippines?
So I think it's still early days. I think e-commerce will still grow as more and more Filipinos, as I said, more users are just discovering it, which is, I guess, I think for many. As the pandemic, hopefully it doesn't last too long, but more and more people will notice the convenience of buying online, finding their essentials. And I think it's a trend that will just keep continuing. But there are three kind of growth areas that I think will make a little bit of a difference. I'll highlight one is logistics. I think logistics will play a massive role for e-commerce. And that's us being able to meet the delivery expectations of consumers, whether you're farther away than everyone who's in Manila. I also think that us working with brands and sellers to create more innovative retail strategies to reach a wider audience will really make a difference to how people perceive buying online. And finally, this whole wave around digital payments, it's going to be this big shift that will just make the whole process a lot nicer, I guess, as it becomes the mode of online transactions.
Mm-hmm. A more seamless experience. You know, Martin, Shopee is not a Philippine company. It's a Singaporean multinational, first launched in Singapore back in 2015. It's a six-year-old company. You've expanded to Malaysia, Thailand, you're in Taiwan, Vietnam, Indonesia, and here in Manila, you're also present, I think, in Brazil, Mexico, Chile, and Colombia. How does the Philippine market stack up? How are we special? How are we unique? Are there superlatives you attach to the Philippine market whenever you compare notes with other directors from other territories where Shopee operates in?
Yeah. Well, it's good you mentioned that we're quite a global company, but we are also very hyper-localized. So actually, if almost everyone, if not everyone in the Philippines focuses on the Philippines only. So it's a nice strategy that allows us to tailor our app to cater what local consumers want, you know. And also helps me highlight the points you were mentioning, what makes us a little different. So I think Filipinos, us, have really embraced e-commerce to go for their daily needs. You know, it's a place that where I buy some groceries, where I buy some diapers, as you mentioned. But what makes us a bit different is that there's a greater demand for engagement and entertainment when people shop here. And I think that's just us as, I'm used to it as well. I want to watch some TV. We see a lot more use of in-app engagement features like Shopee Live. They want to stay connected when they're shopping online. We're all very influenced by celebrities and KOLs. So I think you're familiar. We've partnered with local celebrities like Willy Revillame, Alex for our campaigns, which is really a different, you know, strategy. Filipinos are very social. They want to be talking to people. They want to be, and that's also part of the Shopee Live part, where we see a lot of usage of Shopee Live because people want to be able to sell almost as good as in person.
Martin, would you say we're one of the bigger markets for Shopee, if not the biggest?
It's one of the markets. It's very exciting that it continues to grow very, very well.
Mm-hmm. Okay, exciting. Yeah, go ahead.
There was one more that really, because to me it stands out now. Filipinos are really sulit shoppers. They're bargain hunters. People who really want to find the best deals when they're shopping. And that's again, something that we're trying to highlight, because we know that's how people shop. So in Shopee, that's where you get all those real good deals and promos to enjoy.
Exciting times ahead. I'm pretty sure a lot of our viewers are now adding to cart for the big payday. But as you mentioned, the big ones are coming closer to the Christmas season. Martin, thank you so much for joining us and for sharing insights about the e-commerce and consumer trends here in the Philippines. Thank you and stay safe. See you soon.
Michelle.